It is indeed an honor and a pleasure one more time to be before you. We thank God for this day. This is a day that the Lord hath made, and we are truly rejoicing and we are glad in it. Almighty God, we thank you for this day. Almighty God, we praise your name and we magnify your name. Almighty God, we thank you for your word this morning. Thank you, mighty God, that through your word, we will be strengthened. Almighty God, we thank you, Lord God, for your divine covering and protection over each and every one of us. Almighty God, I pray this morning that your word, mighty God, will go forth with power, with clarity, and with precision. Almighty God, I thank you, Lord God, that you have chosen me to be your mouthpiece this morning. Have your divine way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The topic this morning is divine interruptions are life's opportunities. And the scripture for thought this morning is taken from Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8 to verse 9. And it reads thus, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts." As children of God, we face challenging circumstances every day while we are alive. Even situations that sometimes may seem impossible. But we must understand that in life, we will experience situations or circumstances that are beyond our control. For example, a great relationship has turned sour. It seems as if everyone is against you. Misunderstandings over simple matters. Traffic is heavier than usual, and you miss an appointment. There is construction on the road, and you have to take a detour. Unforeseen circumstances cause you to miss a deadline. Your child or you comes down with some sickness at the very time you're supposed to be going on vacation, or other types of illnesses. Sometimes you may be waiting for some money that was promised to you, but it didn't come in time. Or it may be the fact that you're being stopped by a cop, bad weather, the internet goes down, death in the family, you forgot something at home, and you had to turn around and go back only to learn you missed a bad accident only by a few minutes. These things sometimes may challenge your faith in God, but at the same time, we must understand that there's divine appointment of season and time by God. You may read Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 to 22 in your spare time. Many individuals think interruptions get in the way of real life. Why? Because sometimes you may be too overwhelmed with problems in your lives that you don't allow God's divine interruption to manifest. Sometimes God wants to get your attention, but you are too busy. So he has to use whatever strategy it takes to divinely interrupt you so that you can hear what he has to say. You must be ready at all times to allow yourselves to be interrupted by God's plan for you. The benefits of God's divine interruptions and interventions are unconditional. They are uncountable. They are immeasurable. And for you to experience divine interruption, worry and anxiety must die, because they lead to fear. When divine interruption occurs in your situation, your progress, your destiny, your purpose, and your lives change for better. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9, nor eye has seen, nor ear has heard, and no mind has imagined what God has prepared for those who love him. So thank you for asking that question. What is a divine interruption? Interruption is when someone or something stops something from happening. It also causes a break or stop in action. It may be a conversation, an event, or progress. You are in the middle of something when suddenly an unexpected interruption takes place. During a divine interruption, the one who is interrupting you is God. Divine interruptions are not obstacles to our plan. They are opportunities for us to embrace God's plan and purpose for our lives, because his plans for your lives come with much better plan. So the next time an interruption comes crashing into your idea that you are in control, embrace it and look for the opportunity that God is presenting to you for you to walk in your assignment and purpose. Instead of being frustrated, look for the opportunity to reflect on the goodness of God and what he wants you to see and what he wants you to do. God is the master of divine interruptions. And the Bible is full of examples of how the Lord stepped into situation, of how the Lord intervened in people's lives. For example, Elisha was plowing with 12 yoke of oxen when Elijah found him and cast his mantle upon him. Elisha went on to serve under the ministration of Elijah. The two became separated in life. When Elijah was taken up into heaven in the chariots of fire and horses, 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 11, Elisha received a double portion of Elijah's anointing. Elisha, who came from a wealthy, unknown background, was propelled into being known as the prophet of God. Let us look at little Mary, young Mary. She was a virgin. She was engaged to be married, but God interrupted her life to be the mother of Jesus, our Savior. Luke chapter 1, verse 26 to 31. Moses' life was interrupted by God, from tending flock to leading the Israelites out of Egypt. Exodus 3, verse 1 to 10. When a divine interruption takes place, you discover to your amazement that God is up to something new, something you never expected. Oh, glory to God. You will find out what is on heaven's agenda that was hidden up until now. Isaiah 43 verse 19 says, "For I am about to do something new. See, I have already begun. Do you not see it? I will make a pathway through the wilderness. I will create rivers in the dry wasteland." He is coming into your stuck places. He is coming in to break into situations which has been said, there is no way out of this. God is an almighty God. And that's the God we serve. He's able to move mountains. He's able, more than able to take us out of stuck situations. The Holy Spirit is saying to us this morning, get ready for a divine interruption in which you're going to be so amazed what God is going to do for you. It's going to blow your minds away, so much so that you will sing in songs of praise and you will be rejoicing and dancing. When a divine interruption takes place, you may be pushed out of the ordinary into something new and extraordinary your Father has for you. You may receive information or a prophetic word. You may be impacted by a fresh anointing of the Holy Spirit or have a life-changing encounter with God. In a divine encounter, you will realize that Jesus has been waiting for you. Like the woman of Samaria who came to draw water, Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink," for his disciples had gone away into the city to buy food. John 4, verse 7 to 8. Sometimes in life, it may seem as though you're stuck in your past. You can't seem to get beyond it. It keeps playing and repeating itself in your mind. And here comes all these thoughts: I should have, could have, or would have. And then, suddenly, in a moment, there comes a divine interruption. Everything changes. You realize that Jesus has been waiting for you, expecting you to give me a drink. Give him a drink. You never knew that on one word from Jesus, the whole of your life could turn around. Now you realize with wonder, he has come for you. Yes, it is personal. As Pastor Monique said last week, it is personal. He has come for you. You are in the palm of his hand, and nothing or no one can pluck you out of it. Jesus knows you. Jesus loves you unconditional. And he has a mission that only you can do. The course of your life is about to change. In a divine interruption, God shows up at your hiding place. For some of you, your divine interruption happens as Jesus steps into that secret place. In amazement, when Jesus steps in that secret place, he says, "Peace be with you." The atmosphere changes. Sometimes, like Jesus's conversation with Thomas, he may gently admonish you. But be assured that in that moment, he is doing a great work. Jesus is adjusting you to the truth of his word so that you can hear it. He is setting you free. Fresh anointing and renewed faith is being poured into your heart. When a divine interruption takes place, it is not time for business as usual. That is over. That is gone. Instead, it is time to pay attention to what God is doing. God is about to reveal what he has meant to do all along. So I implore you, get ready, get ready, get ready. Praise the name of the Lord. Divine interruptions are always invitations by God. Divine interruption finds you. You don't find them. A divine intervention will cause any dry bones in your life to come alive. To whom much is given, much is required. I believe that this morning, we as his children are getting a tap on the shoulder by God saying, "It is time. It is time." If we go back and look at all the messages since this year has started, divine alignment, divine shift, and peace be still, and all those messages, even up until yesterday, it is time for your promotion. Is there a divine interruption in your life right now? Be obedient to God's command. Be obedient to his tap on your shoulder. And by doing so, he will demonstrate his mighty powers in your lives. God is about to do something. Can you sense the shift in the atmosphere? Can you sense the presence of God? No matter where you go, atmosphere changes. When you open your mouth to speak, they stand still to hear what you have to say. Walk in this divine interruption in your life right now. Stop whining. Stop crying. God's got you. He's got you. And he will never, never let you go. Almighty God, this morning, Father, we yield our lives to you right now. Mighty God, we surrender our schedules and we release our expectations to yours. Lord, we know you don't need permission, for you are sovereign. And yet, Lord, we want you to know, Almighty God, that you are welcome to interrupt our conversations. Almighty God, our thoughts, our lives, because Father, we know that we can trust you, for you are good and your goodness runs after us and your plans are for our benefit. And so this morning, God, above all, more than anything, we desire you, mighty God. Saturate us completely, mighty God, from the crown of our heads to the very soles of our feet. Father, and we say to you this morning, come, Lord, come, Holy Spirit, and take control in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah.